Guys, this is November, and you know what? This is the first free for the month with FAB, the new marketplace of Unreal. And how is it going to be? Let's just find out, right now.
First of all, there's news. Yes, we're no longer talking about the marketplace, but FAB. And the big change is that we now have 3 content instead of 5. So what's going on? Don't worry, guys. We now get 6 packs of content per month in total, as we receive 3 contents every 2 weeks, and then, theoretically, another 3 packs the following 2 weeks. So, if we do the math, we're actually gaining an extra piece of content. A nice move from Epic. A quick reminder on using FAB. We'll prioritize Add to My Library button to add the content in Unreal format directly to our library, which you can view via FAB or directly on the Epic Games Launcher. On the launcher, remember to click the refresh icon to see newly added content. The Download tab lets you retrieve the pack content in formats other than Unreal, such as ZBrush, source files, DLTF, Unity, or others. And we're starting right off with the Military Airport pack. Oh, these bring back memories of DayZ. Have you guys played that game too? Such good memories. Anyway, we all want loads of diverse Enviro assets and resources because, well, it's great to have a packed toolbox, isn't it? And we're in luck again with over 100 assets in this pack. From simple fences to more elaborate prefabs like the helipad or even this big assembly. You're all set as usual. Be careful though, the airplanes shown here are not included in the pack. It's mentioned but in a very small print. Attention has also been given to materials with a fairly sophisticated master landscape material along with instances for almost every asset, making adjustments and general setup easier. Like the road instance here, which offers nice modularity. Simple but effective, don't hesitate to download this little pack, as always. The next one is a gold mine. If you're looking for materials and system for outlines, symbols and overlay materials, go hit that download button. With a very user-friendly system, its setup and use are extremely straightforward. The creator thought of everything and even provided a tutorial video that explained it all clearly. Based on the maps found in the Epic's game content examples, everything is very well explained and honestly, it couldn't be easier. Well done, Eric. Thanks to a well-designed component and blueprint classes, it will be very easy to adjust and adapt the whole system to your own project. For instance, based on a line trace, you can trigger an event to dynamically display an icon above the character. The same goes for a custom depth-triggered feature, often sought after in video games. This is more content you should grab without hesitation. You'll learn a lot from it, believe me. Finally, we have an animal pack that everyone will need at some point in a project. If you've been on Unreal for a while, like me, you probably know this pack. It's been around since at least version 4.15, I think. So yes, we are getting old. Old but gold, as I say. The plus is that the animals are rigged, of course. In terms of details, it's aged a bit, especially with those air cards that don't look quite as realistic anymore. But it depends on your needs and usage in the project. If you're not doing close-ups, these friends can easily be used as background elements in your scene. Honestly, this pack is worth exploring and using for future animations, or even for creating custom control rigs and practicing with them.
Alright guys, let me know what you think about all this incredible stuff. And see you very soon, like next week, on Tuesday, as always. Ciao!